I recently picked up a copy of the Jak and Daxter trilogy for the PlayStation 3. I'm not going to lie to you, when these games first came out originally, I completely missed them. To be honest, I actually avoided all the great PS2 platformers like Ratchet and Clank and the Sly Cooper series until they got re-released in HD on the PS3. In a way, I'm sad I missed them during their first time out, but at the same time, me and my girlfriend Jenna Bunnikin's having a lot of fun playing through all these games in just one long run. However, there is one game that has left quite a sour taste in our mouths. That game is Jak 2. Now let me start by saying that playing through the Jak and Daxter series was an absolute blast. The characters are great and the gameplay just flows really well. We both thought these games were just amazing. Jak and Daxter was probably the best of the bunch, with 3 following close behind. There wasn't much to complain about overall really, there was perhaps a minor problem with the way Jak jumps, but other than that, these games were just really fun to play. And yes, I even enjoyed Jak 2, even though I'm about to rant about all these problems I felt this game had. Okay, so enough of the praise, here we go. So we completed Jak and Daxter and really couldn't wait to sink our teeth into the second game, so we literally started Jak 2 the very next day. We loaded up Jak 2 and the first of it all seemed rather familiar. The title screen gave a slight impression that this was going to take a darker tone, but we carried on regardless. The game starts in the same place as Jak and Daxter started, which is the hut on Sandover Village, and the two main characters are sitting in a little ship with the two supporting characters, and we both assumed this was going to be another box ticked for an A+ game.
I think I figured out most of this machine. It interacts somehow with that large precursor ring. I just hope we didn't break anything moving it here to the lab.
Easy for you to say. We did all the heavy lifting. Looks like Jak still got the mojo.
Interesting. It appears to be reading out some preset coordinates.
This is how it happens.
A big alien guy sticks his head through the portal and things are going pretty swimmingly. They shoot off into the portal and blam. Straight away, we knew we were in for a completely different game.
It's nominal and unchanged.
Nothing. I was informed that this one might be different.
He is surprisingly resistant to your experiments, Baron Praxis. I fear the Dark Warrior program has failed.
You should at least be dead with all the dark eco I've pumped into you.
There are a lot of changes made to the Jak and Daxter formula, which we both felt was a big mistake. Let me count down the top 5 reasons why we personally dislike Jak 2. Talking.
Say something! Just this once!
I'm gonna kill Praxis!
Yeah, Jak now speaks, which would usually be fine, but it just seemed like he was trying way too hard to be a hard ass. If you weren't aware, Jak was completely mute in the first game, leaving Daxter to do all the talking for him. Now, we understand that for this game in particular, it must have made things a lot easier if Jak spoke, because there is a lot of dialogue in Jak 2, so we consider this a minor problem. Although, some of his lines are just hilariously bad.
It's been a tough ride.
Also, since Jak can now talk, we no longer really cared about him, because, well, he is now a complete dick.
You look like a reasonably smart man. I want information. Where the hell am I?
Sorry. He's new to the whole conversation thing.
Taking inspiration from Grand Theft Auto. I always had my suspicion they saw GTA and decided to go that route, and this year my suspicion was confirmed when I questioned Naughty Dog co-founder Andy Gavin on this point. Anyway, Jak and Daxter was in certain terms an open world game. There were no loading screens between areas and no levels to speak of. However, there was a really nice world layout, which meant that basically there was no need to use a map and no need for a sat-nav system. Both of these things are an absolute must in Jak 2, as the game layout is one huge sprawling city complete with an overwhelming amount of traffic and pedestrians. This is a major issue in this game and one actually killed it for Jenna. A lot of the missions have you getting from one place to another within a time limit, and my god does the driving get frustrating. Let me explain why. So you jump on a vehicle and go speeding off. Now you can fly at two heights, low to the ground by the pedestrians and higher up with the traffic. Now, as previously stated, there is a shitload of traffic, and if you fly at the traffic height, you will not last long before you crash and eventually blow your vehicle up. So you're probably thinking, no biggie, I'll fly on the ground instead. No. You see, if you fly on the ground, you will definitely hit a Crimson Guard, who are this game's version of the police from GTA, and this will cause the whole police force to come steaming after you, complete with guns and ground turrets, and thus, again, your vehicle will blow up. So you're stuck driving around, changing heights the whole time. So you're up and down, up and down, up and down, which is a real pain in the ass. But if you go and look on any forum related to Jak 2, you will see the same complaint over and over again. Don't even get me started on this damn bridge.
This area is off limits.
Jak's use of weapons. Yeah, in the first game it was all fisticuffs like Crash Bandicoot, but now it seems that Naughty Dog saw Ratchet and Clank and thought, wow, guns, guns, and then added them into Jak 2. Now again, like the voice acting, this is quite a minor problem, mainly because I got used to them being there, but the fighting system in Jak and Daxter worked a lot better, I thought. Plus, since aiming with the guns is absolutely terrible, and done by pointing Jak in a direction you want to shoot, and hoping he aims at the enemy you're after, rather than some free aiming mechanic, the guns become a massive problem. Me and Jenna spent a lot of time trying to shoot a specific enemy, only to have Jak tell us, no, I want to shoot this guy instead. Or, more often than not, if there are pedestrians around when enemies are shooting at you and you want to aim for a specific enemy, Jak is more than happy to just aim at the pedestrians and take them down instead. Dark Jak. At the beginning of the game, Jak is being tortured and is exposed to Dark Eco, which turns him into this powerful beast with special powers. This seemed completely pointless to me. I'm not entirely sure what this actually added to the game at all. If Jak didn't have guns, then I would see his purpose, I guess, but to be completely honest, I cannot remember a single moment in the game where I actually needed to use him. There is a scene at the start of the game which forces you to do so and acts as a little introduction to his powers, I guess, but other than that, I just don't know. There is even statues in the game that give Dark Jak extra abilities, and yet I managed to get 102% game completion without touching one of them. So that confirms to me that Dark Jak is a completely useless feature. Now, he does come in useful in the third game, where you also get Light Jak, but even there, Light Jak is used a lot more than Dark. Mission difficulty. Yeah, I know, this shouldn't be a bad thing really, but it's not that the missions are challenging in the sense that I'm not skilled enough to complete them, it's just that they're completely and utterly cheap. One mission stands out from the pack in this regard, and if you find any other top 10 list about Jak 2's bad points, this will definitely be on it, most of the time at number 1. So it kind of comes out of nowhere really. You follow the icon on your map for a piece of the seal that is given to you by Bruta for helping him out. Now when you pick up the seal, the Crimson Guard come out of nowhere and start shooting it. Now this is where it gets utterly ridiculous. Not only are you on a narrow path, but the enemies are also respawning. And respawn they will, again and again and again. I must have literally taken out the entire Crimson Army in this section of the game, because there is no end to these enemies. You kill them and move forward, and then they respawn behind you and in front. Now you're probably watching this thinking, well, Jak can swim, why not just go in the water and avoid the guards? Well, yeah, you're right, Jak can swim, and in the past, I did indeed use that technique to get past some guards that were trying to kill me. But now if you go in the water, this happens. One shot kill. This is the mission that inspired me to make this video, as it is just stupid. Yes, I did manage it eventually, but it was seemingly by complete fluke. It took me forever to do this mission, it's one thing that is stopping me from playing through again on the unlockable hero mode.
I'm hit.
depressing environment. Yeah, I know, I said I was only going to do 5 bad points, but I want to add this one too. Look at the difference here. Jak 1. Colourful, vibrant, and yeah, it even has its dark environments, but it doesn't overuse them. There's a lovely colour palette here with its reds and its blues and its greens and its light browns. Jak 2. Depressing, dark, and a colour palette made up of brown and grey. Now I know what you're saying, Jak 1 was set in the past and Jak 2 was set in the future, and just like real life, man has taken over and concreted over the natural beauty to build stadiums and supermarkets. And yes, I understand that completely, and this is why I added this at the end. However, take away the story logic and just look. Which game draws your eye more? Thanks a lot for listening to me rant, and I'd like to say in respect to Naughty Dog and the Jak and Daxter series, I am in no way saying that Jak 2 is among one of the worst games on the PS2, because it really isn't. It still has its good points, and as platformers go, it is one of the better ones. I just wanted to make it clear that Jak 2 was a disappointment when jumping straight from Jak and Daxter. It was still great to catch up with the characters, and I hope they make a Jak 4 one day. I really, really do, because I would like to spend more time in this world.
Are not going back to Misty Island! Are we?